Good morning, friends. We are in mobile application development using Flutter, and this course is for third year BTech CSE students. I am Arun Desai from Department of CSE, and we are going to see today unit number 2, that is Dart and Flutter. So starting with the Flutter and Dart, basically Dart is a programming language which is developed by Google in 2011, and Flutter is a framework. Flutter is a framework which is basically called open source framework, and this is also developed and supported by Google. We call this Flutter as SDK as well, and the SDK stands for Software Development Kit. So we need to add Flutter SDK and Dart just to work with Android, Dart and Flutter for Android development. Talking about Dart programming language, Dart is mixture of JavaScript, Java and C sharp. When we see earlier scenarios in development of mobile application development, we can see there are multiple languages are in use while working with app development. Basically few technologies which are in use for front-end development is XML, HTML, CSS, etc., whereas for back-end we have Java and Kotlin. We can write business logic, we can write actions for component with those languages. We also have databases like SQLite, Firebase and Swift also for iOS in earlier developments. But after that, Facebook comes up with a cross-platform, and which is called React Native for application development. So Flutter is also a cross-platform development mechanism wherein you can write any web application, any app, mobile application by using this Flutter and Dart combination. So we'll start with Flutter now. Flutter is an open source technology that lets developer create a mobile, desktop and web application using single code base. It's a complete SDK that provides flexibility in developing front-end and back-end applications using a variety of programming languages such as Dart, Java, C or C++ and many more. Flutter also includes a UI library based on custom widgets, a packet of reusable UI element like buttons, text inputs and sliders. Such components are used just to create user interface by using libraries which are available there in Flutter. Talking about Flutter architecture, Flutter architecture comes up with three layers. First layer, which is called as a framework layer. Framework layer built on Dart programming languages and is most visible part of Flutter and provides developer with a rich set of libraries to develop and design a user interface. This layer can be further subdivided into fundamental classes, widgets and rendering layers. Next layer is the engine layer, which is basically written in C and C++ programming, which offers a low-level implementation of the Flutter framework, which includes core APIs such as graphics, accessibility support, text layout and plugin architectures. It communicate with the framework layer to execute the code and render the user interface. So the Flutter basically has its own rendering library wherein it creates its own components. So the reason Flutter is fast and used for cross platform. The last layer which is used in Flutter architecture is embedder layer. Embedder layer is a platform specific and responsible for launching the Flutter engine. it also provides the necessary resources to render the user interface. It enables Flutter app to run on different operating systems and offer a platform-specific interface for engine layer to interact with the native platform APIs. Now, talking about importance of Flutter, basically Flutter is fast in terms of development, in terms of software development, we can say. It saves time because Flutter is work on hot reload feature, and that means if you make the any changes and just you can see those changes in real time, you can see the result in real time without wasting much more time or without restarting the application again and again. So this is what the hot reload facility, which is available, and because of this hot reload facility, development is faster in case of Flutter. Flutter is obviously mentioned earlier that Flutter is cross-platform. Flutter is free and it is open source. It comes up with a beautiful user interfaces components that developer can use just to attract customers. So this is basically about importance. Now we'll see what all things which are required just to installation of Flutter SDK and Android. I'll share you a PDF of detailed installation with how to install those SDKs and Studio. So I'll share the PDF with you all in practical session. So we'll see installation in detail in practical sessions. For now, I'll tell you what are required components which are there for proper setup of Flutter and Android Studio. So first and foremost, initially we require to download Flutter SDK. We need to download that Flutter SDK from official sites, and we need to extract that folder. After extracting, we need to put that folder into drive where you are going to install the Android Studio. Next is, you also need to go into Android Studio official site, and from there you need to install the latest version of Android Studio. It also comes up with multiple plugins. So we are working in Flutter and Dart, so we need to install Flutter and Dart plugins for Android Studio. Now, talking about what all structure which is there for Flutter project in Android Studio. So any Flutter project, when it starts, it is when you want to start, you can start it in Android Studio or Visual Studio Code. The recommended IDE for Flutter is Android Studio. Rather, you can say for Android development, we need to have Android Studios. We must go with Android Studios since it is recommended by Android community as well. So we need to install Android Studio or Visual Studio IDE. On both IDEs, we can develop those applications. So when we start with this Flutter project and when we install this in Android Studio, there are multiple folders which are by default created while we create a Flutter project. So initially there are multiple views available. By default, when you create a project, it starts with Android view. We also have a project view. As a developer, we need to move into project view and after that only we'll get the multiple folders for development. So we'll start with the structure, what all structure available in this in this Flutter project. So starting with first folder, that is called idea folder, which is available in Android Studio. It contains the code editor project related settings, specific file in that folder. We as a developer no need to make any manual change in this folder, or you can say a file of idea there in Flutter project. As a developer, most application developers spend their most of the time in .lib folder or .test folder. As a developer, we can create our own Dart files are there in library file. So basically, though .lib folder and test folders are most important folders for developer. Starting with Android folder. This folder contains platform specific code for Android OS and they are automatically managed by IDE and the compiler. Developer also can make changes, Android specific changes in this folder. We also have lib folder, and this is essential for developer. It contains Dart source files of your Flutter application. So all .dart files are available there in lib folder. You also can create your own files as and when required for your application there in lib folder. We also have a test folder there in Flutter projects. We can have unit test, widget test, integration test, all are there in this in this test folder. We have another file called pubspec.yaml file. This file is basically contains all dependencies and packages available for your application there in this file. So this file contains if you want to have, for example, if you want to have resources, you need to make changes to access those resources in pubspec.yaml file. So basically, if you want to add any resource for your Flutter project, you need to make changes there in pubspec.yaml file. So this is important file. Another file which is available there in project structure is redme.md file. It is typically markdown file and you can find in any Git repository. So if you want to publish your project, you need to have this file there in your project. Thank you, friends, for today. We'll start a next session in next video. Thank you.